FM News. On point. News on XFM. I'm Chris Otim. Political parties under the Inter-Party Organization for Dialogue, an organization known as IPOD, have asked the Electoral Commission to always engage them whenever coming up with drastic changes or directives concerning the elections. Recently, the Electoral Commission scrapped off public campaigns in the districts with a high spread of COVID-19, hence disorganizing earlier scheduled programs. IPOD's chairperson, Justin Kasule Lumumba's message, delivered by the NRM treasurer, Rose Namayanja, states that political parties have agreed that it's outrageous for the EC to just come up with directives without their knowledge.
Before the Electoral Commission makes changes or takes decisions, it's imperative that they consult with the participating political parties before they make those drastic changes or before they issue out directives. It's important that they engage with the political parties or inform them and they have that dialogue such that the decision is well received, and whatever the dynamics, each of the parties together with the Electoral Commission notes the reasons why it has been done.
Meanwhile, the National Resistance Movement has confirmed having completed 98% of the campaign program. NRM's National Treasurer, Rose Namayanja, says they have achieved the target via the media, door-to-door campaigning strategy, and through holding mini-meetings in different districts.
What we know and what we have found out is actually that it has gone to more people than the numbers that he would have met. So much as we would have liked him to be there, of course, being in an area physically has its mileage, but we have taken advantage of the media, the wider coverage of the media, such that the message that he gives to a particular region goes to the various areas.
The National Unity Platform flag bearer for the Kampala Lord Mayorship, Nabila Nagai Sempala, has expressed dissatisfaction over the move by the Electoral Commission to ban cameras at polling stations. The chairperson of the commission, Simon Mugenyi Byabakama, last week warned the public against taking pictures and videos at any polling station because it will be a breach of the electoral guidelines. However, Nabila Nagai says cameras can be used to gather evidence related to electoral violence and ballot stuffing, which will be presented in the courts of law.
That the Electoral Commission is trying to sabotage the technology that we are going to use. We are ahead because they're saying that you shouldn't take pictures. So if people are being killed at polling stations, no one should record that. So I think what the Electoral Commission is trying to issue is unconstitutional. People need to keep their phones. People need to take evidence and pictures of people who have, you know, who are trying to like rig out the people's voices.
Nabila has also asked the public to turn up on the polling day to vote for leaders of their choice.
Go out and vote, because you don't have a gun, you don't have a bullet, but the ballot is your voice. Express it, go out and cast your ballot. Vote the umbrella, vote Robert Kyagulanyi and everybody under the umbrella. Because that's the symbol of unity, because an umbrella unites. It is a tip, it is a cover, you'll be covered under the umbrella.
Outgoing Kampala woman MP Nabila Nagai Sempala. The Archbishop of Church of Uganda, Dr. Stephen Kazimba Mugalu, has confirmed that they will have a dialogue to address their differences in the Uganda Joint Christian Council. The council is comprised of membership from the Catholic, Orthodox and Anglican churches, and currently is chaired by the Catholic Archbishop, Dr. Cyprian Chizito Luanga. The council last week organized peace prayers ahead of the general elections, but they were not embraced by the leadership of Church of Uganda. Now, Dr. Kazimba says their differences cannot be addressed in the media because they have a platform to put their house in order.
About UGCC issues, there are always some internal things which you cannot discuss in public. And as mature people, I am leading a whole church. I know the way to do things is to sit and talk, and we cannot talk about things in public. What I'm saying, let us always learn to resolve our issues internally and not in newspapers. And we continue to do so.
In world news, U.S. House Speaker Nancy Pelosi has shared with lawmakers plans to remove President Donald Trump from office before starting an impeachment process. The House of Representatives would vote on a resolution calling on Vice President Mike Pence to remove Mr. Trump's presidential powers. House Democrats would then introduce a charge of incitement of insurrection against Mr. Trump over his role in the violent storming of the Capitol building. The first votes could happen on Monday. On Sunday, Ms. Pelosi wrote to lawmakers outlining plans for a resolution to formally request that Vice President Pence invokes the 25th Amendment. The move would allow Mr. Pence to become acting president and remove Mr. Trump from the White House. In sports, newly appointed KIU basketball chairman Mark Sally has revealed plans for the club by making it a continental powerhouse in the near future. Sally was recently appointed the new chairman of KIU by the club president Nasser Serun Joji, who also doubles as the FUBA president. Alex Businje and Lama Napio Masaba are the other members of the three-man board appointed to lead KIU basketball. In an exclusive interview with XFM, Sally reveals the plans for the club, ranging from talent identification and development, continental competition, as well as becoming a hub for the national team players.
I'd like to help KIU to develop young talent, to get young people to play basketball, to get us to be able to be competitive here, to bring up the talent, to help feed into the national team, and also to ensure that the competition is wider. The basketball in Uganda has been at league level dominated by one club for quite a bit now. We'd like to be able to get to a level where we challenge that and then ensure that there's more excitement, there's more growth of the game. Like I said, there's more development of talent. And hopefully, as a team here, the strides that the Silverbacks are making are such that Ugandan basketball is on the rise.
And that's the latest XFM news.
XFM News. On point.